guys, it's your girl T. So I want to go ahead and talk about the whole Trinidad James situation. So Trinidad James was on CNN yesterday talking to Don Lemon. As you guys know, the Terrence Howard controversy has been sparking a lot of debate online. So they wanted Trinidad James to come on there and talk about his song All Gold Everything. The demo that SAE was caught on tape saying nigga, 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 basically singing that song. So they wanted Trinidad James to come on there. They wanted to have a discussion with Mark Lamont Hill. And there was another gentleman on there, a white gentleman, I forget his name, sorry. And they're going back and forth about the discussion on who should use the N-word, who shouldn't use the N-word. And so let me go ahead and play you guys the video. I want you guys to check this out. I'm going to come back with the rest of my commentary.
Or whatever. That's why we talk about it and we explain to people what we meant and what we're trying to get across.
Because there was a headline that says you defend. There was a headline that said I defended her as well. I didn't defend her. I said there is what?
I'm not defending
it. There's context.
Yes. It's like I'm not focused on her.
Okay.
I'm focused on these students.
Thank you. You can come here and be my co-anchor.
No, anytime.
All right. So what do you guys think? Mark? What do you think of his
interview? I think it was a great interview. I was glad to hear Trinidad explain himself because, as you said, headlines often distort what people say and what people mean. And I'm always fascinated by the amount of burden and pressure people put on rap artists to police their language. No one asks Tarantino to reimagine the scene in Pulp Fiction where he himself uses the word, the N-word, repeatedly and probably gratuitously, just like in Django. I think it's rappers have an extra burden put on them. And I also think it's fascinating.
He has gotten criticized for that, Mark.
No. There are some people who are now saying that they're critical of him using it. They're not critical of the word being used in the movies per se, whereas with rappers, they're saying rappers just shouldn't use it. Rap music just shouldn't have the N-word in it, or TV shows like Empire just shouldn't have the N-word in it. And what I'm saying is that perhaps that's a conversation that black people can have internally. What I find fascinating is that oftentimes white people are trying to legislate the N-word for black people, saying none of you people should use it. It's like, well, nah, y'all, you know, that's not your call to make.
It's not... Mark, the question comes down to this. Do we want the N-word being used out in society, or do we want to stop the N-word, which has become so, as it is, racially divisive? And I'll be real candid with you. I mean, Trinidad, I think you know...
Did you just say the N-word has become racially divisive?
No, I'm saying right now is the proof of it. Look at all of this and everything that's gone on, and we all condemn it when it's said, but then you want to keep the word alive. And Trinidad, I'll be honest with you. I think you know... that we should probably get rid of the N-word. But in reality, I think many rappers are afraid that they'll lose out on money and sales in street cred if they don't stop using the word.
Go ahead.
Ben, no,
street
sir.
Street cred.
First of all, how you guys doing, Mark and Ben? Welcome to the conversation.
Good to see you, bro.
New co-anchor. Go ahead.
Hey, I'm here.
Go ahead. So what do you think about what he said?
Ben, that's definitely had nothing to do with it. We're not going to take it.
Then why would you keep using it, though? I mean, why not pledge that you're not going to use it?
At the end of the day, Ben, we use the word because that's how we came up. We came up using the word, like, people, you came up using the word in the wrong way. We came up using the word as, how you doing, my nigga? And when somebody say, my nigga, that means that, bro, you're my friend. I will call you, Ben, my nigga. And when I call you that, you do not feel... that I hate you.
But what if Ben said to you, Trinidad, what's up, my nigga? What would you think?
Ben, what I would tell you, if I honestly felt that you were my nigga, then you are my nigga, Ben. Be honest with you, Ben. You understand, Ben.
I'm in the Twilight Zone right now.
I do. Go ahead, Ben.
That's not okay, though. If I use the N-word, it could quite possibly, and honestly probably should, cost me my career. And I don't understand why, when we know how divisive this word is, why we would not have people like you, Trinidad, you're a community, people look up to you, young people look up to you,
yes.
And you're rapping about the word and making money on it, and they think they should be rapping the word
Mark, you can get in after him. Let Trinidad respond.
Ben, you see, you keep giving, you're giving the word too much power. I am making money off of I am making money off of doing music and being creative, sir. I'm not making money just because I use the N-word. Nobody goes to buy an album because it's full of the N-word.
Trinidad.
No, sir.
You wouldn't be on this show tonight if it wasn't for using the N-word in your rap music. Let's be honest.
Go ahead, Mark.
First of all, he wouldn't be on the show if a white woman hadn't said the N-word on a tape. So that's not fair. Again,
which
we're putting
was
the burden on
his
him.
Music.
No, let me finish, Ben. No, first, white people were saying nigga before Trinidad James was born. And to sit here and say that the N-word has become divisive is absurd. The N-word is born out of slavery, it's born out of white supremacy.
I'm agreeing with you.
No, you're not. Listen, just
Why
listen
would
for
we
a minute.
Keep
listen,
the word alive?
Just listen for, this is the problem. When we start talking about issues around race and racism, sometimes white people need to just listen. Just hear what I'm saying for a minute, Ben. What I'm saying is that the N-word isn't divisive. White supremacy is divisive. Slavery was divisive. That's the problem. And maybe, just maybe, it's not white people's position to tell black people what to say. I might see Trinidad James on the street and call him my nigga. You know why? Because he is my nigga. And the difference between Trinidad James and you is that Trinidad James has to deal with the same oppressive situations. He's born into a world where anti-black racism prevails. He lives in a world where police still might shoot him on the street, no matter how much money he has. We share a collective condition known as nigga. White people don't. I'm not saying it should be illegal for white people to use it. I'm saying y'all shouldn't want to use it, given everything that's happened after 400 years of exploitation and institutional racism.
Ben, add on to that, Ben. Ben, the reason why you wouldn't use the N-word, Ben, is out of respect, correct?
Bingo. Right. I think it's a racially god-awful word that we should get rid of, because, and we shouldn't be teaching it to young kids, no matter what their race is, because it is so hurtful, and as long as we continue to use it, it is going to continue to hurt people's lives, and we should join together and say, this is a word we can all deal without having around, and it will bring more people together than divide them.
Okay.
All right, so you guys just watched the video, and before I get started, first of all, let me get this out the way. Dad James hair was fried, dyed, and laid to the side. What, honey? His hair was on fleek. I was like, damn, he got butters. So anyways, that discussion to me was crazy. I guess my thing is this. I don't understand why some white people are so obsessed with the N-word. Why they're so, you know, adamant on, you know, banning it. If they can't use it, nobody can use it. Well, a lot of white folks use the N-word for years and years, and they used it, they abused it, and everything else. You know, I would understand, you know, his plight if he was also against gay people calling each other, you know, the F word, or, you know, calling each other fruity and things like that, or, you know, women calling each other bitches. It seems like nobody else is on a crusade to ban any other word but the N word. I don't understand why some white folks are just so obsessed with trying to ban this word. Well, if we can't say it, you guys can't either. Well, I mean, if that's the case, why should anybody say anything derogatory? You know, I'm just over the whole N-word situation, the whole going back and forth. Like I said in my other video, I'm going to go ahead and insert that clip in right now. Even though a lot of people claim to use that word as a term of endearment, we also have to realize the other side of that word as well. When you call somebody a nigga, it can also be derogatory, because a lot of times we say that not just as a term of endearment, but as a way to, you know, cut somebody down. Like, we about to go right out on them niggas. Fuck them niggas. Fuck that bitch. That nigga ain't shit. And I hate using those type of words, but those are words I grew up around, you know what I'm saying, living in the hood. It's a lot easier to go right out and go kill somebody and go hurt somebody and go jump somebody when you look at them as just some niggas. But it's a lot harder to do that when you look at somebody as a brother, as a sister, as another black man, as another black woman. You see what I'm saying? So we try to put on this fallacy that, oh, it's just a term of endearment. Like, what's up, my nigga? I love my niggas, my nigga, my nigga. You know what I'm saying? Yes, there's that part of it. But then there's that other part of it too, where we use that word to loathe each other, you know what I'm saying? So it's not always a term of endearment. It's like, man, when we see them niggas, it's on and popping. When we see them niggas, we riding out. You know what I mean? Nobody's gonna say, when we see them brothers, we're about to go right out on them. We see them brothers, we're gonna kick their ass. It just doesn't even sound the same. So I think that we need to stop fooling ourselves and try to make it seem like it's just a term of endearment, but that we don't use it in that negative connotation as well. You know, granted, it may not be the same context as when a white person says, oh, look at that nigger, you know what I'm saying? But when we say, oh, I'm about to ride out on them niggas, what's the difference? You know what I'm saying? We're still using it in a derogatory way. You know what I'm saying? Like, we need to start looking at each other in a positive way, as opposed to the first thing that we're thinking. We see a whole bunch of black people. Look at all these niggas up in here. It's probably about to be some drama. Too many niggas in the house. You know, so I think that word definitely has a negative connotation as well. All right, so you guys just watched what I said in my Terrence Howard video, because that applies right here. You know, so many times you try to act like the N-word or saying nigga is just a term of endearment, but like I said, it's two different ways, and we need to stop acting like it's just simply a term of endearment, when a lot of us and a lot of people have used that word to belittle, to degrade, and to, you know, hurt each other. You know what I'm saying? Us in the black community. So, I mean, the whole N-word debate, I don't see that debate going anywhere. But I did like, you know, the stuff that Trinidad James was saying. He did come off more articulate in this interview. And shout out to him and kudos to him for fixing that missing tooth. He done took that money and went to go see a dentist. I'm not mad at you, honey. You look so much better. So anyways, go ahead and leave a comment. Let's go ahead and get the discussion popping. Let me know your thoughts on this entire situation. Do you feel like, you know, nobody should say this word? If white folks can't say it, neither should black people. Or do you feel like, you know what, anybody can say any word? It is what it is. Or are you like me? I'm to the point where I feel like, you know what, if you're somebody of a different race and you say the N-word, you have the right to say the word because it is freedom of speech. But the thing is, you better be careful who you say it around, because for every action, like I always say on my channel, there's a reaction. And not every black person is down with that term. Not every black person sees that word as a term of endearment, even coming from other black people. So you have to be very careful if you're somebody of another race and you run around talking about, what up, my nigga this, my nigga that. You might just get punched, and that's real talk. So, you know, while people are free to say what they want to say, you just have to gauge people, because everybody's not down with that word. Don't let these rappers fool you and gas your head up. Every black person don't run around saying that, you know, nigga. Every black person don't look at that as a term of endearment. So you got to be careful. You got to tread lightly. So anyways, go ahead and leave a comment. Let me know your thoughts on this entire situation. Let's go ahead and get the discussion popping. What do you guys think about it? Should the word be banned? Are there certain people who should be allowed to say the word and not allowed to say the word? So let's go ahead and get the discussion popping. Go ahead and leave a comment. All right. Deuces.